I grew up on a family farm in Livingston County, and I know full well what it takes in order to be successful at farming. And it certainly takes a lot of sweat, a lot of hard work, but it also takes things like financial resources, as we know. So this truly is crucial to our future here in New York State, to our economy.
Senator Cathy Young supports measures to keep family farms in business, as well as to incentivize young people to create a career in agriculture. Welcome to Your Voice. I'm Julia Locandy. Hi, Senator.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you doing?
I'm doing great.
Great. So thank you for coming in to talk about ideas to help New York's leading industry.
Well, it's really great because Senator Ritchie is the chair of the Agriculture Committee, and she does a fantastic job in putting forward initiatives and proposals that really help strengthen agriculture. It's still one of our top industries in New York State. As I mentioned in the tape, I actually grew up on a dairy farm, and I used to milk the cows and help my dad and my grandfather when I was little, and I just loved it. So I understand how difficult a farming life can be. It's very rewarding, but it's also very challenging. And so we want to make sure that we have farmers into the future, and we need to make sure that we as a state are promoting the right policies so that happens.
So recently, local farmers throughout your district came to Albany to meet with you. Let's start with Cattaraugus County.
Right, so this is actually Tim Bigham, Nathan Blessy, Chuck Kucher, Shirley Zilker, Dave Zilker, and they're being presented with a proclamation because the Farm Bureau was celebrating its 100th anniversary in Cattaraugus County, so they've been advocating on behalf of farmers that long. I have to tell you, when I was first elected to the Assembly in 1998, one of the first groups I met with was the Farm Bureau, and they do a fantastic job advocating on behalf of agriculture. And, you know, I've been on the Agriculture Committee ever since I was elected to the Senate in 2005, mm-hmm. and it's been really fantastic because we've been able to build the maple industry, the apple industry, the wine and grape industry, dairy industry, you name it, we've been able to strengthen it in New York State. And it bodes well not only for our economy but also for our consumers because the real trend is safe, fresh, and local. And that's really what consumers want, and we're able to do that through agriculture in New York State.
Right, and Chautauqua County farmers met with you as well.
That's right. So this is Dick Kimball, Joanne Nacero, Aaron Urban, and John Knight. John Knight is on the far right of the screen, and I have been to his family farm many, many times. The last time I was there, his granddaughter was playing in the mud, and we got a great shot of her because she had mud all over her face. But it really shows that they had to travel a long distance. Chautauqua right. County is as far away as you can get in New York State from Albany, and so I truly appreciate that they came all this way.
And Livingston County Farm Bureau as well.
And they're very special to me also, and that's Rob Noble and Andrew Smith. And as I said, I grew up in Livingston County, so it's very special that they are here also.
So you got together with everyone that we just spoke about from all of the counties, and what did you guys discuss?
We talked about state aid in the state budget. As you know, we're going through the budget process right now. I serve on the agriculture subcommittee, so we're negotiating the ag part of the budget, and there are several programs that are vital, especially some of the research programs that go through Cornell University. The other issue has to do with Cornell Cooperative Extension, and we started a program a couple of years ago to really strengthen cooperative extension, and we want to make sure that that funding gets in the budget again because it provides technical on-the-ground assistance to our farmers across the region, and that's incredibly important.
So they go into the farms and provide advice for how they can strengthen their farms?
Exactly. So, you know, in the dairy industry, for example, how farmers can increase production. And that's really important in Western New York right now. I have several dairy processing plants in my district, you know, Empire Cheese, for example. We have Dean Foods that produces things like sour cream and things that consumers want. But we also have a growing, thriving yogurt industry, mm-hmm. and especially Greek yogurt. So that's really been something that's been very beneficial to our economy. And, you know, people think about agriculture and they think about farming, and we need to support our farmers. But also there are so many jobs in these processing plants, and it all adds together to create billions and billions and billions of dollars of economic growth in our state.
Right. So the Senate Republicans put out a Young Farmers New York initiative, I think that's what it was called. Tell us why it's necessary to attract the younger generation into agriculture.
Well, the average age of a farmer in New York State right now is 57 years old. And so we have family farms, but, you know, quite honestly, a lot of the farms have gotten to be more medium-sized and larger farms, and some of the smaller farms have gone out of business. And so these family farms need to be passed along to the next generation. We have to find ways to get people into the family business or to attract new farmers. I've talked to several people who maybe, you know, had careers as police officers or some other career earlier in their lives, and they've decided that they want to go to the to establish a farm. So we need to make sure that we have this next generation of young people coming up. And it's everything from agriculture, education in our school districts. Mm-hmm. And so Future Farmers of America were here recently. But it's more than that. It's creating an environment in New York State where these young farmers can get into the business.
So talk about some of the younger people that visit you in Albany.
Well, we had young students from the Sherman Central School. And this is Gabe Rader, Jessica Morton, and Brandon Van Curen. And they came to see me in my office here. And again, I salute them because they had to travel so far, probably about 6 hours to get here. But they are very enthusiastic young people, very involved in Future Farmers of America. They come from family farms, some of them don't. And I think that's fantastic too. So they're not growing up on a farm, but they're still interested in agriculture as a possible career, which is exactly what we're talking about here.
Right. So a farmer came to Albany as well to show his support for this plan. He's a 27-year-old. Let's take a look at that right now.
A young farmer exiting college with large student loan debt and an unestablished credit with a young family to provide for, I know firsthand the difficulties of obtaining a private business loan. Incentives such as the Young Farmer Revolving Loan Fund and Young Farmer Innovation Grants will help us alleviate the financial burdens of starting one own farm, as well as creating resources to develop new technology and new farming innovations. Agriculture is a dwindling industry. With the average age of a farmer being only 57, we need to encourage future generations to take on the responsibility of providing wholesome and nutritious food for our state.
So part of this plan will help with, as you said, land and equipment that is really hard for especially new farmers. Tell us how that will help.
Well, you know, it's very difficult to get started, and I commend that young farmer that we just showed, and he and his wife are taking the plunge and putting toward resources, their own resources toward farming. But our young farmers also need help. So we would look to establish $5 million in startup loans. That's incredibly important to have those startup loans available to young farmers. Mm-hmm. And we also would be able to allocate up to $50,000 through a competitive grant program. And so it would help young people like that person. You know, when you look at this and look at our future, this is really something that is incredibly important to our country. If we can't produce our own food, then we're really in trouble. And we have these young people who are very eager, want to get into the business. We should encourage them as much as we can. It's so cost prohibitive,
right?
Because it's capital intensive. You know, for example, if you're going to plant corn, you have to go out basically and borrow the money for the corn, plant it, harvest it, and then you recoup what you put into it. If for some reason there's too wet, too dry season or whatever, and you don't, you're not able to have the crop that you want, you're behind. And so there are so many challenges that face farmers. And we want to make sure that they have the resources necessary so that they can thrive.
Yeah, there is a lot of risk. So I would like to show our viewers your comments at the news conference the other day.
In the Senate, we understand very well what agriculture means to the economy of our state and also to the future of our state. Everybody has to eat. And we have made tremendous progress in every sector of agriculture. And now we have the responsibility as lawmakers to make sure that we can take agriculture to an even higher level. But if we don't have the next generation in place,
to take over the family farms, we're going to be nowhere quickly. So we need to do all that we can from a policy standpoint to ensure that we have the strength of farming. And I salute our young farmers, and especially you, for being here today. You did a great job, but this is our future in New York State. And we need to make sure that we are cultivating, no pun intended, but we're cultivating that future. And this really is the way to do it, through this package of legislation.
So as you mentioned before, this provides an educational aspect. How would that help students like the future farmers of America?
Well, there are so many lessons that can be learned through agriculture. And basically, when you're a farmer, you have to be a jack of all trades and master of everything. So it's everything from financial planning and being able to manage, you know, your finances, to being able to have relief as far as estate planning. You know, we're looking to reduce the estate tax in New York State. That would help future generations of farmers, because, you know, right now, if you inherit the family farm, you have to pay so much in taxes that, you know, it's prohibitive. So we're looking to reform the estate tax law in New York State. We call it the death tax also, but we're looking to reform that. I'm very happy that the governor included that in his budget proposal. That's something that the Republican senators put forward a few months ago. Senator DeFrancisco, who is chair of the Senate Finance Committee, traveled around the state and was able to come up with a whole package of tax relief programs. We still are the heaviest tax state in the country, and we are fighting so hard to reduce those taxes. We get blocked out of New York City quite often. Right now you see the mayor of New York City wanting to raise taxes again. We're stopping them. But we need to create an environment in New York State where our small businesses, including our farms, can thrive.
Right. Farm Bureau President Dean Norton made a perfect example of why that is so important. And he says, you know, this isn't just for the rich. This will help a farmer. Let's take a look at that.
A young farmer who was milking 150 cows, valued at $1,500 a cow, that's $225,000. Say he's got 300 acres, valued at $2,500 an acre, that's $750,000. And he's got to have equipment, let's just say a moderate number of $100,000. That total, folks, is $1,095,000. That doesn't sound like a very wealthy man to me. Sounds like a farmer that's trying to make it in the world, a small farmer, a family farm trying to feed his family and take care of his community.
I know the Senate is putting out their One House budget. Will this be included? And I know that there are other measures regarding energy that you would like to see that could really help farmers as well.
Right. So we are putting together a One House budget right now. We should be passing it very shortly. And people say, well, One House budget, what does that mean? What that means is the governor put out his budget proposal in January. We've been having hearings and subcommittee meetings to examine every part of the budget. Now it's time for the Senate to put forward our plan. The Assembly will put forward their plan through their One House budget resolution. And then we get everyone together at the table, so it will be the Senate, the Assembly, and the Governor to negotiate the details. Our plan for young farmers will be included in our One House budget resolution, as will other issues. For example, you mentioned energy. We need to reduce the cost of energy in New York State. Right now, my phones are ringing off the hook in my district office because people are very upset about their utility bills. So for example, we want to eliminate the 18A tax on energy that was put into place when we were not in the majority in the Senate and New York City controlled everything in the state. We are pushing to eliminate that. That not only would help farmers, it would help all small business owners, but every single residential consumer, senior citizens, families struggling to pay their bills, so and so on. This would help so many people.
Yes, it would. So thank you so much for being with us. Next time you come back, we can talk about the broader range of the budget and the contents that is included.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Julia.
All right, thanks. Thank you for watching Your Voice with Senator Cathy Young. For additional information on the budget and the Young Farmer New York program, log on to the Senator's website, young.nysenate.gov.